Brendon, so we're sitting in front of your farm store here, and obviously under construction, and it looks like it's going to be a beautiful place. Just a lot of unique features here, and just tell me about it. We're going to take a look around, and I don't know, it's a good thing for people to see sort of a different model than I think is out there. So,
yeah, so we made the decision when we started the farm that we wanted to run a model that focused on on-site sales to go along with some of the restaurant and wholesale business that we at the time had planned to do. We knew that we were going to get started with an open-air farm stand and develop an enclosed farm store with wash pack, cold storage, and garage storage for our tools and equipment on farm. So what we did is we built a post and beam frame from the ground up out here. This is just real simple 6x6 post construction. Really, it's just a basic shell with a concrete floor, and we clad it all with locally milled lumber from a place over in Eflin, North Carolina. So all of the live edge siding and board and batten siding and some of the interior finishes are all locally milled trees turned into lumber. Nothing more sustainable for a local farm store than cladding it in local lumber. So,
got a real rustic look to it, real natural. I think it fits in on the farm really nicely.
Yeah, so we wanted it to be very beautiful, and it will be when it's complete. It'll get a metal roof over the front porch. Obviously, the porch area will be elevated and brought up to a proper floor. The whole road will be elevated coming into the garage. Wash pack on the other side will be pretty well dialed in. Wash pack leads right into our walk-ins, which then on the store side we'll see in a minute are actually merch coolers like you would see in a traditional grocery environment. So folks can shop right out of the coolers from the store side, and we can load them from wash pack.
Cool, and very much appreciative of you showing us, obviously, during construction here. But so, just so people understand, the farm store is going to be in the center here. And then off to one side behind you right now is going to be the wash pack station. And then over here is going to be the tool storage.
That's correct. So you basically got sort of what we used to call them raised ranches where I grew up. You basically got a two-story structure in the middle with a single-story wing on each side. Everything was built to a simple dimension where we're using modern lumber dimensions to create the space. So we've got a 24 by 36 footprint in the middle, and then each wing is a 16 by 24 footprint off of it. Garage and tool storage on the right, wash pack and processing there on the left, and then the farm store in the middle. And then the second story of the farm store is predominantly storage, but will one day be hopefully a studio for Airbnb rentals and stuff like that, people visiting the farm.
All right, cool, let's go check it out.
All right.
So we're in your wash pack area, and this is right next to the coolers, which sort of separates the wash pack from the farm stand, but you guys just finished up in here, so.
Yeah, we just finished a shift in here this morning, so when we come in from the CSA pickup, the last thing the folks will do today is clean everything down, wash all the bins, wash and sanitize all the surfaces, sweep up, take out the trash, call it a day. But that happens after we finish at the CSA pickup on Saturdays, because we rotate our stock, go through everything, divide up what we're going to give to a couple of the charitable organizations first of the week, and start to assess our needs for harvest on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday of next week. So yes, wash pack is almost done. We've got everything insulated and vapor barriered. We will condition this space so that when we're working in here in the summer, it will be air conditioned for the staff and for
That's
the good
huge.
Of the vegetables.
That's huge.
We've got a greens drying rack needs to go in here at the end of our line. Then we'll have an ice machine and a hand wash sink. And that's after we put the cladding on the walls. And we are moving towards GAP certification, as there are no GAP certified farms in Durham County right now. So the county has an initiative to help a farm achieve GAP certification. And we're working with them this month on that initiative. And we'll button up the final couple of things in here, get the power finaled, turned on, and then be good to go.
All right, so this is set up for washing greens or roots, or what's going on here?
Yeah, everything. So we actually have a preliminary root wash station outside. So when roots come out of the field, they get an initial wash and bunching that happens outside. And then everything comes in here. Even if it's been through the root wash station, it is still treated as dirty produce coming into wash pack. So the harvested produce gets weighed in and then stacked on the processing tables. And from there, it goes through either a triple rinse or a triple bubbling system up on the draining deck, and then through a traditional restaurant spinner, or is allowed to drip drain on a drying rack. And from there is processed into our totes, whatever needs to happen to it, and then moved into the walk-in.
So obviously a lot of thoughts gone into this area here. I also am really happy to see floor drains and a concrete pad and stuff that you got to put in at the beginning that goes a long way for a long time in the future.
Yeah, absolutely. So one of the most important aspects in GAP certification is one-way flow. So you always want to bring your dirty produce or products in and have them work right along a bit of a assembly line, if you will, into the wash or rinse or sanitate solution, coming out of that solution clean, and then the clean produce continuing down that one-way flow into the processed or final packaging, whether it's bagging, toting, and then into the cooler. And then the center island here is really the final step on anything that needs to be bagged or bunched or weighed or portioned in any way. So one-way flow, concrete floor drains, just proper planning from a sanitation perspective, a workflow perspective. You know, when there's two or three people in here, if we're working on a one-way flow, we're not tripping over one another. Everyone has sort of a job to do and a station where they're working, and things just move through the line. So when things come down the clean line here, whether they are bagged after processing or they're put into a storage tote or storage container, lid put on, they'll move into one of our two walk-ins. Now, please don't mind all of the cords and everything. We are still in the middle of construction and we don't have our permanent power connected yet. We chose to go with two separate walk-ins so that one could be kept at 1 or 2 degrees Celsius or 34, 36 degrees Fahrenheit, and another one kept around 50 degrees so that we can use it as our tomato ripening room or storage for the produce and vegetables and herbs that like to be kept at 50 degrees high humidity rather than right at 34, 35 degrees like your greens and things like that.
And so on the other side, so we're going to go check it out in a second, but that's where the farms end. They'll be able to reach in. And so this literally doesn't have to get, you put it in there and you're good.
That's right. So, you know, again, we just finished a shift. As you know, we have our CSA pickup happening today. We have one cooler that is not running yet and another one that we run a few days a week on generator power. Otherwise, we still use an offsite walk-in in a commercial location here in town. But yes, the coolers, once they are up and fully functional, you can access them from wash pack, store your product in the coolers, and then both coolers have merch doors or merchandising doors like you would see in a grocery or mercantile space, where from the store side, people are shopping out of this space as you would in the grocery store when you reach in and pull out your milk and somebody's back there reloading the milk while you're purchasing from the other side. So really designed to not only divide the space between the two functions, but also have the coolers
double as a display cooler.
Double as a display cooler, that's right. Anybody that's set up a farm store or is setting up a market garden understands how very expensive refrigeration is. If then we've got to go into the store and drop merchandise coolers in as freestanding units, they're just thousands of dollars per freestanding unit. And it was much more practical for us to get dual use out of our walk-ins than tie up floor space and additional dollars on freestanding refrigeration in the store.
I also see this as a very efficient way of running your farm stand, because you could have a lot of people in here shopping and just that flow wouldn't have been broken by people restocking, because it's just happening behind the scenes.
That's right. And much like we do out at the farm stand, we have a couple of staff on hand to help service the 50 to 60 members that we see in a short period of time. And when we're open and business is taking place in the store, The store will be very much self-serve in that we should be able to run pretty much the entire store side with the cashier. And then behind the scenes, we will have somebody here in wash pack and in the coolers that's actually restocking during that short period of time that we're open. With finite space on the reach-in shelves, we will have to consistently restock that during our open hours.
All right, so we're inside the farm stand now. So this is the other side of the coolers that we're just showing. Talk us through what's going on in this area.
So longer term, this is going to be an enclosed conditioned farm store. A lot of the inspiration for the farm store and for the interior of the farm store was really from pictures on social media that I've seen of Elliot Coleman's farm stand up at Four Season Farm in Maine, as well as is it Daniel Mays at Frith Farm, also up in Maine. Both stores, I think, have a beautiful aesthetic inside, a lot of natural wood in use, really beautiful displays of vegetables, things like that. Little hot down here in central North Carolina in summer, so a slightly different approach here. Rather than everything being open on tables, we wanted to go ahead and provide two sets of reach-in cooler doors where we could market all of our produce without ever interrupting that cold chain. And then within the store itself, we will have other crops and local products that people are more accustomed to seeing out on display, be it onions, potatoes, corn, things like that, that doesn't need consistent refrigeration during the few hours we're open. So again, really just designed our coolers for double duty. The other thing to note is that we did go with two walk-in coolers, both driven by CoolBots and entirely built out of used walk-in panels and products. So with the exception of the two doors that you saw on the other side, which are new doors, which we were advised is your best investment in the walk-in cooler, everything from the wall panels to the ceiling panels to even these merch doors was used or reclaimed on the used market. And there are companies out there that specialize in just used refrigeration components. And then they were site built in the space itself to fit the dimensions that we wanted them exactly. You know, some of the other things that we did in planning the construction of the farm store was introduce a lot of reclaimed lumber and materials. So we have this wonderful local sawmill here over in Eflin, North Carolina. They milled for us all of the board and batten siding on the exterior, as well as what they call the live edge siding up top with the bark edge still exposed. Most local lumber mills and places like that will have pick piles where when they were milling lumber, they'll have piles of seconds that might have had knots or holes or bark still left on it that wasn't perfect for the order they were cutting. Most of these places will stack that stuff to the side and bundle it and offer it for sale in bulk. And for the most part, it's just allowed to weather there in the elements. So we went in and negotiated with the local mill to go ahead and let us purchase basically all of their surplus pick pile lumber from around their facility. And what we did is we put it through the planer, ripped it up and air dried it for a couple of weeks. We took the flame weeder to it and actually torched some of the pieces to bring out the grain and darken it up. We used the best of the material for the ceiling finish, the worst of the material for the wall finish. And then I'm not sure if I saw it at Frith Farm, but it seemed like one of them did this beautiful subway tile up top of their walls above the wood paneling. So we'll finish this upper area of the store with a really nice white subway tile, and we'll have a little bullnose piece of lumber here to sort of break between the wood and the tile. We'll hang some signage off the ceiling, and we'll have more display and merchandised areas here on this wall, all kind of highlighted with some directional track lighting above and things like that. So we put a lot of thought into having a very warm space, having a very well-lit space, having a very convenient space, and also having an exceptional cold chain for all of our product here so that we can really maximize shelf life and quality by the time it reaches the customer.
I have to say air conditioning is gonna be huge too.
And we insulated the space, and as soon as we're hooked up to the grid, there will be air conditioning for both the store and wash pack. We are not air conditioning upstairs at this time, and the garage side of the building will be left open air.
But from a customer experience, like that's
for
awesome.
The customer experience, for the products that are sitting out in the store, and really for the well-being of our staff.
I was going to say, like, I've washed in my garage and it's air-conditioned. It's awesome. Now we're outside and right. It's a big difference.
Yeah. You see it in on the faces of our staff as we're awaiting air conditioning and wash pack. If it's 95 degrees and 90% humidity outside, it's 94 and 90% humidity inside. So we are looking forward to having a conditioned store and a conditioned wash pack space for the benefit of our staff and our produce. So the customer benefit, I think, will be a given. And that will, of course, allow the customer to stay in the store longer, be more comfortable with their shop when they're shopping. And if you provide a comfortable and convenient and well-lit atmosphere, your sales will be higher. It's simple retail science, and we want a comfortable customer that feels that our process here is convenient and accessible for them. All right, so in this corner, we've got our little checkout counter. We wanted to make things as lean and as efficient as possible, really maximize the space of the square footage we have in use here. So we are going to be topping the counter with some large slab wood coming from the same lumber mill we used for everything else. We have under cabinet lighting that's already been wired into the checkout counter, as well as wiring in its own circuit for a small beverage cooler or merchandise refrigerator underneath the checkout counter, because most of our customers are parents. And as any of us parents know, when you go to the store, what the kids want most is what's right by the checkout and down at their level. So this is where we will have honey sticks and natural local candy, maybe some natural local beverages, and things that the kids might tug on their parents' pant leg to include in their checkout. So again, just trying to use a little retail science here to make sure that we maximize the value of each customer coming through the store.
Very smart. A lot of thought went into this place. I can't wait to check it out when it's done.
Yeah, that makes two of us, actually. It's been a long time in the works. The whole team has worked really hard on it. All of this construction is done in-house. We have a dedicated construction person on staff. I really wish Lou was here today and not on vacation so you could meet him. But he's really been the one to do the vast majority of this interior finish work. And has really helped even guide me through some layout and planning and, you know, some placement of accent lights and some key things you need in a mercantile space to really make it flow well and feel like a mercantile space to today's consumer that's used to going into Whole Foods or their local food co-op, and all of those places are engineered for retail science from the time you step in the door to the time you leave. And we've just taken as many cues as we could from people that are already winning. So
very cool. Thanks for sharing, and a lot of stuff for people to think about. And I think it's a great investment for the business and for the farm and for your community to have an awesome experience when they come in and shop. So very cool. Thank you.
Definitely. Thank you.